Welcome back to the channel. This is Wei Hao at Direct Impact Solutions. In this video, I will show you how to count how many groups you have in your subsummary report. In this demo file, I have a very simple report. When running, the report will list contact names and emails, and these contacts are grouped by their company. Our goal here is to have a number next to the company name in the subsummary part, so that this number will increase for each company included in this report. For example, the first company will have number one here, and the second company will have number two here, and so on. So how do we do that? Well, first, let's create a subsummary field that will count how many records are in a group. We do that by do a count of the primary key. And then let's create a calculation field. So in this calculation field, we will use the getSummary function to get how many records are within a group. So for getSummary function, you have two parameters. The first one expects the summary field, and the second one expects the break field. For the summary field, it was the one we just created. And for the break field, since we want to know how many contacts are under a certain company, the company is the break field. We're not done here yet. So what we want to do is to do the reverse of this and then have another summary field. Let's call it group count, which will add up the calculation value that we just created. Make sure to check the running total so it doesn't reset after each group. So the math here is very simple. What we want to do is to have a field increase by one for each company. Assume you have X number of contacts under a certain company. By doing the reverse of it, you have one divided by X, and then by taking the sum of it, you have one divided by X times X again, which gives you one. So this guarantee, this summary number will always increase by one for each group you have. If you have multiple parts, you can create multiple sets of these fields to get the counter for each group. So what's left to do is just to add that field to the layout. So first company, one, second company, two, third company, three, fourth company, four, and the fifth company, five. I think that's the last company. There you go. The demo file is linked in the description below, so don't forget to try it out yourself. And that's the end of this video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time.